With all the news coming out that Intel ME is a backdoor or has major security flaws, you have good reason to be suspicious of the secondary chipset inside your system. With this video, I will show you that removing Intel ME is not as hard as it seems, especially if you have a motherboard with a removable BIOS chip. Even if you don't have a removable BIOS chip, you can still follow most of this guide by buying an adapter that clips directly onto your BIOS chip. As long as you match the pins of the adapter to the ones I show in the video, the process should be identical. Just to save myself, I need to warn you that there is a possibility that you may break your computer, although extremely unlikely. You will need a Raspberry Pi with Raspbian, an SSH client, a BIOS flash chip plus adapter if non-removable, and a breadboard with wires. Make sure to turn off your computer before starting. We're going to start by removing the CMOS battery from your motherboard. Every computer, desktop, or laptop has one. Next, the BIOS flash chip is removed and then placed into a breadboard. Make sure to note two things. First, the chip model number, usually on the second line, and second, where the small indent on the chip is. Sometimes, this appears as a small dot on the upper left of the chip. The indent indicates the top of the chip, and numbering starts from the top left. There are about 8 connections we need to make for the flash chip. However, 3 of the pins on the BIOS chip are connected to one Raspberry Pi pin, the 3.3 volt power line. Here's a quick video of me connecting the Raspi to the flash chip. At this step, I bridge pin 3 of the BIOS chip and pin 8 of the BIOS chip, as well as pin 8 of the BIOS chip and pin 7 of the BIOS chip. Insert your SD card that already has Raspbian in it. Open terminal and go to the boot partition directory on the SD card. Then type touch SSH. If you're on Windows, open Notepad, save an empty file called SSH to the boot partition. Make sure when you're saving the SSH file, the file name is enclosed in double quotation marks. Plug in your SD card, Ethernet cable, and power to the Raspberry Pi. Go to your router's homepage and look for something that says DHCP or DHCP client list. You can see the Raspberry Pi right there. Copy the IP address and SSH to it. The username is Pi, and the default password is Raspberry. Now, we're going to enable SPI on a Raspberry Pi. Type sudo raspi-config. Navigate to Interfacing Options, SPI, and enable it. Hit Finish. Then reboot by typing sudo reboot. SSH back into your Raspberry Pi. Open your browser and search for ME_cleaner. Go to the GitHub link and click wiki. Then click external flashing on the sidebar. Copy the wget command and paste it into your terminal. Do the same for the rest of the commands. However, the last make command may fail. There are a few prerequisite software we must first install. Type sudo apt install libpci-dev libusb-dev libusb-1.0. After completing it, try running make again. If it fails with the message, all warnings being treated as errors, you can fix it by typing nano capital M make file and scroll down until you see warn error. Change yes to no, press Ctrl X, Y, enter. Try make once more. You can also type make-j4 to make it run faster. Now type period forward slash and paste in the flashrom-p command from the website. Use the arrow keys and delete the flag that says dash C chip model. This will cause flashrom to loop through all possible chip models until the proper chip model is found. In my case, two models were found that matched my chip. I chose the model name that was most similar to that of my flash chip. Copy and paste in the same command as before, except this time, change the model name after the dash C flag with your actual model. Now there exists a dump of the flash chip called originaldump.bin in the current folder. As a backup, we must do one more dump. Copy the command we just ran, except change the file name at the end to originaldump2.bin. Finally, run the diff command from the webpage. If there's no output, there are no differences between the two files. Copy the git command from the webpage. Change to your home directory by typing cd tilde. Here, I don't have git installed, so I install it by typing sudo apt install git. Then, I run the git command. Next, run the cd coreboot command. Then, make. Copy and paste the ifd tool command, except add the directory of our file for the file name. Make sure to type period forward slash, and then paste in the command. If your output looks anything like this, then your dump was successful. Next, go back to the webpage and click the link to the me_cleaner repository. Copy the web address and go to the terminal. Change your directory to the home directory by typing cd tilde, and then type git clone followed by the GitHub web address. Change your directory to the me_cleaner folder. Go back to the external flashing page and run the command that says python me_cleaner.py-c original_dump.bin. Make sure to add the flashrom directory before the file name. It should pass all the checks. Now, we will copy the command under the neutralize intel.me heading. If the website ever changes, make sure to use the command I'm showing here. Add a dash lowercase s before the dash o. Also, type in the directory of where your original flash dump files were right before both file names. Now, we will flashback the modified image. Copy the command from the webpage. From the terminal, change your directory to the flashrom directory, and then type in period forward slash and paste the flashrom command. Change chip model to what you had earlier. Press enter and watch as the new image is written to your flash chip. Intel ME has successfully been removed from your computer. Remove all the cables carefully, making sure not to short anything, and insert the chip back into your computer. Make sure that the orientation of the chip is the same as what you had recorded earlier. Finally, We need to reset the CMOS settings using either a metal paper clip or pin. Find the CMOS reset header or pins on your motherboard and short the terminals. Some laptops have slightly more complicated methods. You can usually find the needed steps by searching online for both your laptop model followed by CMOS reset. Reinsert the CMOS battery and then power on your computer. It may take a while for your system to boot for the first time, so don't worry. And there you have it, Intel ME disabled. Check out my next video if you want to confirm that Intel ME is no longer running on your computer.